You are nothing more than a lying sack of shit.
That was the moment I realized I'd never been more in love with Gina French. But like so many foolish guys before me, I'd fallen into the friend zone early on. I mean, I spent 5 years of my life doing everything a boyfriend would do without the benefits of actually being a boyfriend.
All three of us are going to create online dating profiles tonight. I'm so excited.
Hey. The thing is, average guys, we don't get hot girls. Name one girl that would find me attractive in a sea of dudes with six packs. I've got more like a kick.
You know how easy girls who date online are?
So I figured instead of taking a bunch of unwanted criticism, I'd just do what every average Joe does when he tries online dating.
It's like looking in the mirror.
It was the world's greatest joke against the world. Until...
I sent him an email this morning. Oh.
It's early, Steve.
He's totally hot.
To come clean or not come clean? That was the question.
Hope you got soundproof walls, buddy. She's gonna be knocking boots all over that house in no time.
I've totally fallen for Surly Steve. He's like the perfect guy.
Gina, you never know who you're talking to on the internet, right? I mean, that could be anybody.
I know. I watched To Catch a Predator. I think a lot of girls would have thought you were pretty cute.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. With this face. Great.
Yeah, with that face.
You're pretty awesome.
So are you. What's wrong?
What's about the whole online dating thing? That guy you've been talking to?
Kevin, don't start putting your surly spin on my relationship with Steve.
Don't you mean surly Steve?
You humiliated me in front of everyone. The one person I trusted above everyone lied to me. How do you think that made me feel?
Tell her how you feel. She might be pissed as hell at you, but she's still your best friend.
For the first time in my life, I felt like you saw me outside of the friend zone.
I have news for you, okay? Nothing in this life comes in a perfect package.
Oh, you made that quite clear.